kids news. I hope you guys have had an incredible week and that you're ready for this week's video. But before we get into anything, I know what you're wondering. Who's that? Well, ladies and gentlemen, that is Barry the Bear, my co-host, and fun fact for you, he and Skippy are best friends. Okay, so first up, we're going to be doing a leaders challenge, and doing this challenge is Jonty and Gemma. And what they'll be doing is a drawing challenge. They'll have to draw each other. And the cool thing about this is you guys are the judges, so you have to decide who is the winner. I want you guys to look for creativity, detail, color, uniqueness, and you guys can decide and leave a comment down below who you thought won. So over to you guys.
I'm going to be doing the memory verse for today. So here it is. When I am afraid, I will put my trust in you. In God, whose word I praise, in God I trust and am not afraid. What can mere mortals do to me? And that is from Psalms 56, verses 3 to 4. Now, what we're going to try and do is we're going to do this, but I've got some pictures to help us remember it because it's boring to just memorize words. So I've got some pictures to just like help us remember it a bit better. So here we go. When I am afraid, I put my trust in you, in God, whose word I praise, in God I trust and am not afraid. What can mere mortals do to me? And that is, as you know, from Psalm 56, verses 3 to 4. So I just want you guys to remember, anytime you're feeling afraid or worried, just remember this verse and remember that you can just turn to God and put your trust in Him and you don't have to be afraid anymore.
Thanks so much, Bryony. I hope you guys enjoy the memory verse and also that you remember it for the talk that's coming up after the musical segment. And speaking of the musical segment, I hope you guys are ready to have a fun dance right now. Okay, get out of your seats and be ready to dance.
Let our praises remind all the darkness of how great and how mighty our God is. For the battle belongs to the Lord and no one else. We are standing in holy defiance. We're declaring aloud in the silence that the battle belongs to the Lord and no one else, no one else. advances as we take back the ground from the darkness. The battle belongs to the Lord and no one else. You're the banner we raise in the chaos. No, the gates of hell won't stand against us. The battle belongs to the Lord and no the troubles, the trials, the shadows, the sorrows, the long nights, the hard fight. We are the prophets, the voice in the darkness, declaring the battle is yours. We'll sing hallelujah for all hell to hear. Shout out Hosanna above every fear. Strongholds will crumble like castles of sand.
Fascinating story from the book of Daniel chapter 3 about a big and powerful king, King Nebuchadnezzar, and three men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and how these three men trusted in God even when they were being threatened by the king. So the story starts off with King Nebuchadnezzar deciding to set up a huge statue of gold. The Bible says that this statue was 60 cubits high. Now, to put things into perspective for you, imagine around the size of your dad. Now, times that by 20. Yes, 20. And that was round about how tall the statue was. Pretty tall, right? I know. And the king made everyone in the province bow down and worship the statue. But one day, some of the king's fortune tellers came across three men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and realized that these three men were not bowing down and worshiping the statue like the king had said. So they decided to tell the king, tittletales, if you ask me. And when the king found out that all these allegations against Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were true, he became furious. So he called them in, and in verse 15 says, "Now, when you hear the sound of the horn, flute, zither, lyre, harp, pipe, and all kinds of music, if you are ready to fall down and worship the image I made, very good. But if you do not worship it, you will be thrown immediately into a blazing furnace. Then, what God will be able to rescue you from my hand?" Then Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego boldly reply in verse 16. "King Nebuchadnezzar, we do not need to defend ourselves before you in this matter. If we are thrown into the blazing furnace, the God we serve is able to deliver us from it, and he will deliver us from your majesty's hand. But even if he does not, we want you to know, your majesty, that we will not serve your gods or worship the image of gold that you have set up. Wow, pretty bold from Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And as expected, the king became even more furious at them and decided to make the fire 7 times hotter than before. Now, I was already scared when he said he was throwing them into a blazing furnace. Now he was making it 7 times hotter? I don't know about you, but I would be completely terrified by this point. So Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were tied up, fully clothed, and were thrown into the furnace. And the fire was so hot that even some of the king's soldiers who were taking Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego got killed along the way. Which, sorry for the king, but it's kind of a backfire. Get what I did there? Backfire. Furnace fire. Haha, get my pun. Anyway, after that, something amazing happened. The king realized that there was movement in the fire and that now there was 4 men now walking around the fire, unbound and unharmed. 4 men? Weren't they just 3? Who's this other guy? Where did he come from? And I guess the king had a similar reaction to me, because in verse 25 he says, "Look, I see 4 men now walking around the fire, unbound and unharmed, and the fourth looks like the son of the gods." Now to King Nebuchadnezzar, this fourth person might have just looked like a son of the gods. But we know today that this could have very well been the Son of God. But what I find so cool about this verse is that even King Nebuchadnezzar, someone who didn't believe in God, still could see that there was something very special about this fourth person. After that, the king asked Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego to step out the fire. And once they do, the Bible says they were completely unharmed. Verse 27 even says they didn't even have the smell of smoke on them. Now I'm sure we all know the power that fire possesses. If we put anything in it, it usually melts, burns, or disappears. And even if you're around fire, you always get the smell of smoke on you afterwards. For example, take these different materials of clothing. If I put them in this fire, they eventually start burning up and disappearing. Or this. Or even this one. Scary, right? And obviously, I wouldn't put an actual person in the fire as an experiment. But I hope that you guys get a gist of how amazing it is that Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego came out completely unharmed. After seeing this, the king and all his people were completely shocked, as anyone would be. And in verse 28, he even cries out, "Praise be to the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who has sent his angel and rescued his servant. They trusted in him and defied the king's command and were willing to give up their lives rather than serve or worship any god except their own." The king then promotes these men and tells everyone in the land to only worship Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego's God. Isn't that amazing? Seeing how God can change this king's stubborn heart into a heart that can see God's amazingness and see for God for who he really is. But wait, isn't the same God that we see in this chapter? Isn't he the same God who's with us today? The one who was protecting Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in the fire and who was faithful towards them? He's the same God that we have that can be faithful to us and protect us during our hard times and difficult situations. All we need to do is trust in God and be obedient to his word, like how Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were obedient to him back then. That's so amazing to see. Before I leave you guys, I just want to leave you with a few questions to reflect on. Maybe you want to call your parents and discuss these questions with them. The first question I'd like to ask is, are there regulations in your culture or country or maybe even school that restrict you from worshipping God fully? What are they, and how is this chapter going to help you be faithful to God even in those times? Secondly, what is it that made Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego not fear the fire as much and be able to step into it? How can we possess that today to be able to step into our difficult times? And lastly, who is with us today when we go through difficult times? Thank you for listening.
Thank you so much, Julia. I hope you guys enjoyed that talk as much as I did. Now, before we go, we're going to just have Sam, who's going to close off in prayer for us.
Thanks, Bella. Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you for letting us learn more about you. And Lord, we trust you to keep us safe through these tough times. In Jesus' name, amen. Back to you, Bella.
Thanks so much, Sam. Hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Also, don't forget to comment down below who you thought won the Leaders Challenge. And we hope to see you guys next week. Bye!